American robins are basically the quintessential bird to describe the onset of spring. Hilariously, though, more often than not, individuals who witness their, quote, first robin of spring are probably seeing the local American robins who were roosted up just a few yards from their back door. Now, don't get me wrong, American robins are definitely migratory birds. Heck, their scientific name is half about this specific fact, though I'm not sure what's up with the other half. In winter, American robins will travel to areas where they have easy access to berries, usually in open woodlands. They spend a lot more time in the trees, and they're more difficult to spot as compared to their spring and summertime locales. In many areas over the American robin's range, they don't have to migrate far to find a suitable site to overwinter. Therefore, that first robin of spring might not be as travel-weary as one might think. It all really just depends on location. In the summer, American robins can be found in backyards, gardens, parks, open fields, and forests, pastures, and shrublands. They don't waste time looking for a partner because over the course of the breeding season, a female may lay up to 3 broods of eggs. Males court females with tail and feather waving, as well as singing. The robin's song is one of their defining characteristics, as they are almost always the first bird to begin singing in the early morning. They certainly are the early birds who get the worms, and snails, insects, and fruit. Supposedly, when American robins eat nothing but honeysuckle berries, they can get drunk. That just makes me wonder if there are FUIs in the bird world. If a male's song wins a female's affections, they'll mate and she'll lay around 4 robin's egg blue eggs. It's thought the eggs are blue to help protect the developing embryos inside from the rays of the sun, though that's just a theory. It'll take about 2 weeks for the chicks to hatch, during which the female will incubate the eggs. 2 weeks after hatching, the chicks leave the nest, though it can be another 2 weeks before they're ready to fly. Until that time, both mom and dad will still bring them treats to eat. Although the longest living recorded American robin was nearly 14 years old, on average, they don't have the longest life expectancy. Many young robins don't even make it to their first birthday. The ones who manage to live to become adults, however, are about 10 inches long, have a wingspan just over a foot, and weigh less than 3 ounces. And no matter at what stage of life they may be, American robins can fall victim to predators. Eggs and babies are vulnerable to snakes, rodents, and other birds such as crows and blue jays. Adults are susceptible to hawks, larger snakes, and domestic cats. Adult American robins are grayish birds with bright orange or red chest feathers and dark heads. The females tend to appear more pale than males, but their color can vary just based on where they live. Because American robins eat mostly berries in the fall and winter, they can be seen as pests competing for food resources. But at the same time, during the summer, they help control insect populations which could be damaging to crops. So, it's a give and take. At one point in history, American robins were actually eaten, and their meat was considered a delicacy. Nowadays, though, they're protected by the US Migratory Bird Protection Act. For more facts on American robins, check out the links in the description. What do you think of these beautiful birds? Be sure to give a thumbs up for robins, and thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.